We're talking about the pituitary gland, and we just talked about the posterior lobe. Now we're going to talk about the anterior lobe. But I want to put everything back in context again, that the pituitary is sitting here in the cella turcica, which is also diagrammed here in the illustration, and to highlight that vascularity. And again, it's the master gland. It's connected to the brain via the pituitary stalk. And in this section, we're going to talk about the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland. The anterior lobe of the pituitary gland is also known as the adenohypophysis. And it is, again, regulated by the hypothalamus, two nuclei within the hypothalamus called the arcuate and the periventricular. I'm not going to ask you to remember the difference between periventricular and paraventricular, but so we're not going to draw too fine a point on that. But what I need you to understand is that the neurosecretory cells of the arcuate and periventricular, again, when these neurons fire, they're going to release neurotransmitters. They're going to release those neurotransmitters into a great big vascular complex in the stalk, in the pituitary stalk. And this is called the hypophyseal portal system. A portal system, which you were probably introduced to in the circulatory MOOC, is where you go from capillary bed to capillary bed before you go back into the larger circulation of the body. So these neurons are going to secrete their products into a vascular bed here, capillaries, that then go to the anterior pituitary. The arcuate and paraventricular nuclei of the hypothalamus regulate the anterior pituitary by releasing factors that are called either releasing or inhibiting factors. So these guys make releasing factors or inhibiting factors that come down through this capillary bed and then act on cells in the anterior pituitary. The cells of the anterior pituitary then release tropic factors. These are what go into circulation and go out to influence all of the other endocrine organs throughout the body. So the anterior lobe of the pituitary responds to factors created here in the hypothalamus they're listed here. So the anterior lobe responds to factors from the hypothalamus, and these include corticotropin-releasing hormone, gonadotropin-releasing hormone, growth hormone-releasing hormone, prolactin-releasing hormone, thyrotropin-releasing hormone. So they're very wordy, lots of words, but the words tell you what they do. We'll take one for an example. Corticotropin-releasing hormone acts on the anterior pituitary, which then will secrete a hormone called adrenocorticotropic hormone. And I'll talk more in detail about those tropic hormones when I talk about the individual endocrine organs. But then this hormone will then act on the adrenal gland. So right now, when we're talking about the pituitary in this part of the MOOC, we're talking mostly about how the hypothalamus regulates the anterior pituitary, and then the anterior pituitary regulates all the other organs. There are also some inhibiting factors, and these include growth hormone inhibiting hormone, or somatostatin, and prolactin-inhibiting hormone, which really actually, they didn't know what it was in the beginning, but then they figured out it was actually dopamine. So it kind of has two names. And here are the list of things that are, or peptides or hormones that are released from the anterior pituitary. So we talked about, in the last slide, we went over all of the stuff that the hypothalamus secretes into the pituitary. These are the releasing factors that the pituitary then secretes to all of the other organs. So that's where we have adrenocorticotropic hormone, follicle-stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, growth hormone, prolactin. We usually don't call it prolactin hormone, but we just call it prolactin. thyroid-stimulating hormone and melanocyte-stimulating hormone. These are the hormones that are going to enter circulation and act on your other endocrine organs to regulate their function. So we've talked about the pituitary and the hypothalamus, how the hypothalamus regulates the pituitary, both anterior and posterior lobes, and how the pituitary hormones then regulate the rest of your endocrine glands. In summary, what is homeostasis? Just to get back to that basic premise, what areas of the hypothalamus control the anterior pituitary? What nuclei of or areas of the hypothalamus control the posterior pituitary? What hormones are released from the posterior pituitary? Be able to name the releasing factors secreted from the hypothalamus and the inhibiting factors secreted from the hypothalamus, and then what hormones are released from the anterior pituitary. So this is kind of a big assessment. There's a lot more in this one because the pituitary and the hypothalamus are kind of the keys, the gateways to understanding most of the endocrine system. But once you have a grip on this, and it might take you a little studying, but once you have a grip on these basic facts, then you'll be ready for the assessment.